This is Jane Ara, and welcome to Hubian Channel. So for today, as you can see, I'm still on my bathrobe, and yeah, I'm already here in the hotel. And for today's vlog, I will be telling you like my experience when I checked in here in Okada Manila Hotel.
So here guys, you can see we are arriving the entrance of the hotel. So this is the Pearl Wing entrance. When you arrive at the entrance, you will need to pass through a chamber. And inside the chamber, you need to wait at least 8 seconds. In there, they will smoke you. That's the right term. So I think it's to sanitize you, so you need to wait at least 8 seconds before you can come out. Then before you make it to the entrance door, you need to surrender your baggage for inspection, and you need to pass through a sensor wherein there will be like a camera, and the security will ask you to look at the camera. So when we were looking for our way to our room, we saw the casino. So based on our research, we learned that Okada has one of the largest casinos in the Philippines. So here guys, when you arrive in the elevator, you need to make sure that you have your key card ready, because you're going to use your key card and swipe. Is it like swipe? But you just need to put it like in front of the sensor of the elevator so that you can click the floor that you desire. So here I was able to show you guys how I placed the key card and the sensor, but yeah, it's just in the like on the bottom of the numbers of the elevator. So yeah. In your room, guys, there's like a seal, so you don't need to worry. You just need to swipe in your key card, and then after that you can open the door, and here we are in our room.
So upon check-in guys, you will need to make sure that you have your booking confirmation ID, and you have the proof that you really have a booking for that day. And also guys, you need to make sure you brought your ID. So the ID should contain the same name that you used in your booking here in Okada Manila, because that's the one that they will check, okay? And after that, when you arrive at the reception area, you will need to give all of those information to the receptionist, and then she will check on their system if you like to confirm that you really have a booking for today. And then right after that, you just need to wait for a few minutes. For us, we booked using Agoda. So Agoda is like a travel booking site. So we booked there, and we booked July 21 to 22, just one night stay, and it was in promo, so we had a discount. Instead of paying 19,000, we just paid around 11,000 including taxes already. We paid the whole amount when we arrived at the hotel in the receptionist area. And if you have someone together with you on that booking, they also need to present ID. You need to sign some things or some documents for their documentation and also for your reference. And you will be checking in, or we should check in supposedly at 3 p.m. Philippines time. But we arrived here around 12 noon, and then lucky for us, the receptionist was so nice. She said that she found a room, an empty room, and a ready room for us, so we were able to check in early, free of charge. So imagine, so nice. So even though the room is so far away from the elevator, but hey, it's Okada. So it's very famous. Okada is very famous. It's a very expensive hotel. I believe I saw like a vlog that they have a room worth 1 million per night. And I also saw another vlog saying they booked like 60,000 per night. So imagine. It's like for the rich, guys. So it's one in a lifetime that I could be able to experience this kind of hotel. This is the first time ever. Moving forward, yeah, we were able to check in early, and then we asked if we still need to do the swab test before we check in, and they said that it's okay. Only 18 years old below and above 65 years old are the ones that need to do a swab test. Here in the hotel, they have a ready swab test here, so you can avail that. That's worth around 1,000 pesos. So I'm not sure like if it will increase or decrease when you book in this hotel in the future, but yeah. So before you go to your room, you need to make sure that you ask for your key card. So the receptionist will ask you if you want one or two keys. So depends on how many you are in your room. So this room, this deluxe king room, is max of 2 adults. We just got one key card because I believe me and my husband will not go like separate ways for just one day. So when you get your key card, guys, you will see here your room number. There you go. As you can see, that's our room number. That's 1733. And you need to make sure that you have this one because you cannot go to the higher floors. And before I forget, guys, this is the sample acknowledgement receipt. So we got it in an envelope. So the envelope's so nice. I'm gonna take this home. So you will have this acknowledgement receipt. You need to sign the acknowledgement receipt because this is the other thing that you need to know. You need to prepare a cash deposit. So for us, they asked us 5,000 cash deposit, but I overheard from the other receptionist when like I have like in line with me, he was asked like around 15,000, I guess, for cash deposit. Maybe it depends on the room. I think it really depends on the room. So they just asked us 5,000 cash deposit. So you should have cash. You cannot give a cash deposit in, I don't know if they will accept credit card or debit card, but what they said is they need cash. So cash is the cash deposit. That's why it's called cash deposit. So you need to have cash on hand.